So in this lesson, I'm going to show you how to monitor Docker using Prometheus, and then we are going to create dashboard in Grafana. So first step is we need to enable Matrix on Docker, and for that we need to edit etc docker daemon.json file. Okay, so we need to, if you are on Linux, you need to edit this file, but if you are on Windows Server or any other, you need to follow this documentation. So since I'm on Linux, I'm going to go to the server where we have Docker installed, and by default, if you see the file doesn't exist, in that case you can just go on and create the file. So I'm just going to open this file, daemon.json, and then we can see currently file is empty. So I'm just gonna paste these two lines there. So just make sure whatever way it is mentioned here, you copy the same exactly, you copy the same way, and then we are going to just save it. Now we also need to restart Docker services, so I'm just gonna do sudo systemctl restart docker. Okay, now that's perfectly fine. Now we are going to add this new system matrix which we have created to Prometheus, because now Prometheus needs to know that Prometheus also needs to pull Docker related matrix. So for that we are going to go to, currently I'm on the server where we have installed Prometheus as well. Okay, so in my case Prometheus is also on this server, but in your case it might be on different server, so you need to go to Prometheus server and then modify prometheus.yml file, and here in the targets now we need to add a new target. So what is the target which we have created? I guess you guessed it right. So we need to say targets, and then we need to add localhost. And Docker is sending its matrix on this port, which is 9323. So I'm gonna say 9323, and that's it. Everything looks okay. Now we can save and exit from here. Also, we need to restart Prometheus because we have made changes in Prometheus configuration file. So in order to restart Prometheus, just do sudo systemctl restart Prometheus. And also, if you want to just check the status again, just make sure you check the status just to ensure that everything is perfectly running. So we can see everything is running. Now let's move on to Prometheus. And in Prometheus, I'm going to run this query. So this query is going to tell us how many Docker containers are currently running. So I'm gonna click on execute. And right now we can see now Prometheus is able to collect all the metrics. Prometheus is saying that right now I have five Dockers which are in stop state, Docker containers which are in stop states, and there is no running container, and there is no container which is in paused state. Now if you want to verify this, and if you are new to Docker, in that case you can go to Docker documentation and you can see the list of commands which are available here. But basically if you want to see all the Docker containers, so in that case we need to run we need to go to the server where we have Docker installed. So I'm just gonna first clear the screen, and then we are going to run docker container ls hyphen a, and this is going to list all the containers. So here you can see, you can also count the number of containers, so it is matching. These are five containers which you can see here in Prometheus output as well. So it was saying that we have five containers, all of them are in stop state. Now what will happen if I run one of the containers? So let's see, I'm going to run a new container. I'm gonna call it docker run, and we want to run httpd. So it's a new container now which has been running. Now let's go to Prometheus and try to execute this query again. So right now new statistics have not come. It's probably gonna wait another 10 seconds when we are able to see new stats. Now you can see we have one container which is showing as running. Okay, so you can see that now Prometheus is able to pull new data. So we are going to use the same query, and we are going to go to Grafana, and we are going to add a new panel. Let's add an empty panel. And this time I'm going to use, let's say I'm gonna use pie chart, because we have not used pie chart as of now, and I'm going to paste this query here. And now we can see that we are getting the data here. It is saying that there are five containers which are in stop state, there is a container which is in running state, and here it is showing us the data. Now I'm just gonna change the formatting here. I'm gonna put state. So we only see running, stopped, or paused. And now also I just want to change the label to table. I don't want to keep list, I just change it to table. And also I want to show some values, which is gonna be values. Okay, so we can see that we have running one, we have stopped as 5 containers. I'm just gonna click on apply, and also let me just quickly go on and change this. So I changed it to Docker container status, and now we are just gonna play a bit more. I'm just going to run a couple of more containers. Now let's see if we are able to see the updated status here. Now you can see we have two containers which is in running state, and so right now total it is saying we have 7 containers. Let's again verify it by doing Docker container ls-a 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8. So here we have 8 containers, so it is still refreshing. Yeah, you can see now 6 of them are in stop state and 2 of them are in running state. Now I'm just gonna remove a couple of containers, and then I'm going to give image ID of some of the containers which I want to remove. So I'm just gonna give all of these container ID here, and let's say we end up removing some of them. Okay, so some of the containers have been gone, have been removed. So now these values should be refreshing pretty soon. Now you can see we only have 5 containers, and 3 are in stop state, 2 are in running state. So you can now see how easy it is to monitor Docker using Prometheus and then showing the visualization in Grafana. So that's all in this lesson. See you again in the next lesson.